Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to set up your workspace panels and windows in Adobe InDesign. When you're first starting out in any Adobe program, it can be really hard to know A, what those windows do, and B, which ones you're going to need for your projects. So I'm going to show you my workspace setup, but absolutely feel free to customize this because your projects are probably not going to be exactly the same as mine. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I'm here in Adobe InDesign and I'm just going to start a new file. I'm going to go to print and then we'll choose letter and then we'll create. And it doesn't really matter what kind of document you open, just anything is fine. Now, so we all get to the same starting spot, let's go to Window, Workspace, and Essentials. And then we'll go to Window, Workspace, and Reset Essentials. So your screen should look somewhat like mine now. Now I'm going to come up here to Window and just start opening all the windows that I usually use. We'll come down here to Color. I want that one open. I also use Swatches a lot. And when I do that, it puts it in this little tiny bar. I'm going to go ahead and expand that bar right here. I always want Control open, and that's this top bar. And this bar changes based on what you're doing. So if you have something selected, it'll change based on whatever that is, whether it's text or an object. So it's really nice to have open all the time. I want my layers, my links, my pages, my stroke panel, and I also want my character styles and paragraph styles. When I open one of those, it'll open kind of this whole bundle of styles. Now, I often use character styles and paragraph styles, but I don't use style packs. So I'm going to click right on the name and pull that out of the bundle, and then I'll just close it. And then under type and tables, I want character. And I think that's about it. So now that we have all the panels open, it's time to rearrange them. I've got CC libraries here. I know a lot of people love those, but I don't use them. So I'm going to pull them out by clicking on the name, dragging it out, and clicking the little X to get rid of it. I also don't use properties. So I'll get that one out and close that one. I'm going to go ahead and expand these panels just so I can see what I'm working with. I want color up here at the top, so I'm going to click on the word and just pull it right up here until I get a blue highlight. Now, if I drop it in here, it's going to go into a bundle with pages, but I want it on top of pages. So I'm going to move up a little bit until I get this little bar, and then I'll release. I also want my swatches right in here, so I'm going to click on the name and drag it up until I get that bar. And I'll double click the word to see more options. Now pages I actually want over here. I like pages in their own column. And now I have too many columns and not enough workspace. I'm going to go ahead and put character at the top of this list. And then I'll put stroke right underneath character. And I'll expand that. Now layers, I'm going to pull that out. I've changed my mind about layers. I don't actually want this in my workspace. I can just hit F7 and toggle it off and on. So I'll do that if I need my layers. So I'm going to get rid of that. And then these two, I want to put them down here at the bottom. I accidentally clicked too high and now I've undocked these. So to dock them again, all you have to do is click on that very top bar and just go all the way over to the edge until you get this little blue line over here, and then release, and it'll dock them all again. Now I want paragraph styles under here, so I'm gonna pull that out, and then I want character styles in the same one, like we had it, kind of bundled together. So I'm just gonna click on that word and put it right here until that one is highlighted. And then we can move these around in here like that if we want. So I'm going to put this right underneath links, and you might have to turn off your bottom bar. To do that, it's Option Command D on a Mac, probably Control Alt D on a PC. So I'm going to put this right under stroke like this, and I'll expand strokes. So now my character styles and paragraph styles are right here at the bottom. Now I don't need my pages to be so wide, so I'm going to get right on the edge of the pages column and just pull this in. And same with this column. I don't really need them to be this wide. but InDesign won't allow me to have it too small. So the way this workspace is set up is perfect for me now. I have lots of room still in my document, and I have all of my most commonly used windows over here to the right so I can easily access them. So now I want to save this. So to do that, I'll go to Window, Workspace, and New Workspace. And I'm just going to call this A. I'll want to make sure both panel locations and menu customization is checked, and then I'll say OK. And now the really nice thing about this is, let's say we decided to, you know, open some other panels, we move things around, and everything is all crazy like. Now we can go back up to Window, Workspace, and first you'll want to click on the workspace you want, and then go down to Workspace Reset A, and it'll put everything beautifully back to where it was. So that's how to set up your own workspace, and it'll help you become more efficient in the program because you'll be able to get to everything faster. I'm in the process right now of creating a full course on InDesign. So if that's published, it'll be right up here at the top of your screen. All right, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just subscribe and click the little bell next to it so you'll receive all the videos when they're published. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.